Hello everyone. First of all, I would like to say welcome for everyone. My name is Hakan. I am working for Mavili Electronic Company. And today I'm going to talk about selection of the fire alarm system cable types. First of all, what is the loop? Loop, it is the definition of zone connected by cable, forming a single line with the device or devices on it. Each loop is independent of other parts of the system. Connection cables are managed by devices and devices monitoring and control devices on the circuit. In order to prevent natural or human errors that may occur, affect the whole system, the system should be controlled by dividing it into circuits. The cable which is connected to the sounder beacon like output devices must be fire resistant, but the cable which is connected to the detector and manual call point like input devices might be both. According to standards, the cable resistance against fire must be minimum to 30 minutes. First, cable types. Cables must comply with the requirements specified by the equipment manufacturer or supplier. Special attention should be paid to the current carrying capacity and the weakening of data signals. To protection against fire, cables should be routed through areas of low fire risk. If cables must be routed elsewhere and faults that may occur in these cables may prevent the following. Either fire resistant cables should be used or the cables should be protected against fire. Receiving a detection signal by the detectors. Receiving a detection signal by the manual call point. Activating alarm devices. Receiving signals from the fire detection system and voice evacuation system. Thus, fire resistant cables should be used. Standard fire resistant cable must be meet the PH 30 classification when tested according to EN standards, and also a 30 minute survival time when tested according to Annex AE of this standard. Advanced fire resistant cables must be matched with PH 120 classification when tested to EN standard, and a 120 minute survival time when tested to BS standards. The consequences of the fire don't affect the target of the fire detection and alarm system. The following paragraphs provide recommendations to achieve this goal. Cables can be embedded in the building structures. Cables can be protected by laying inside pipes, or cables used to fire detection and alarm system should be separated from other cables by at least 0.5 meter. Cables are installed only in areas protected by automatic fire detection. Additional, in case of fire, the following cables must work for a long time. Connections from the low voltage main supplies distribution board to the power supply unit of the control and indicating equipment and other power supply units used as part of the fire detection and alarm system. Interconnections between the separated parts of a distributed control and indicating equipment. Interconnections between a main control and display equipment and a mandatory repeater control panel. Appropriate protection will be provided so that they can operate for 30 minutes. This can be achieved in one of the following ways. Using of cables with a PH 30 performance as specified in EN standards. To protect the cable with fire-resistant structure designed to ensure the performance of EI 30. Protection against mechanical damage. Cables must be adequately shielded. Cables can be attached to cable tray, channels, etc. If installed, it must be separated from the other cables. They should not be installed in the same tray with low voltage cables. If there is only one tray for extra low voltage and low voltage cables, they must be separated from the low voltage cables by a metal physical barrier. 4. Protection against electromagnetic interference. In the choice of cable and route selected, the necessity of preventing electromagnetic interference from other cables and sources of electromagnetic radiation should be taken into account, especially in the case of systems such as addressable device circuits, where cables are used for data transmissions. To prevent electromagnetic interference to fire alarm signals, the recommendation of the fire alarm equipment manufacturer regarding to separation of fire alarm cables from other service cables must be followed. The choice of cable and route should take into account the necessary to prevent electromagnetic interference from other cables and electromagnetic radiation sources, especially in the systems where cables are used for data transmission, such as addressable device systems. In this table, you can see which cables should be used. Loop cable for detection and monitoring should be halogen free and flame delayer. Loop cable for detection, monitoring, warning, switching and controlling should be halogen free, fireproof and flame delayer. This means the part of the cable installed through the vertical cable shaft. The other system cables like sounder beacon cable, supply cable between devices with external 24 volt supply requirements and auxiliary power supplies, communication cable between panels, repeaters and gateway control units in the buildings with more than one fire alarm, cables for supply and switch monitoring between smoke damper and damper modules, supply cable between magnetic door holder and relay control module, communication cable between emergency firefighter telephone and panel. All of them should be halogen free, fireproof and flame delayer, except supply cable between magnetic door and relay control module. It cannot be fireproof, it doesn't matter. And also for the loop cable, it can be just halogen free and flame delayer. Thank you for your participation. If you have any question, please send an email to export@mavili.com.tr. Also, please follow us from Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, Instagram and YouTube with Mavili Elektronik Global account.